Hey there, everyone. The main surveyor here. You may remember this photograph. You may have seen it before. Not labeled up in this way exactly, but I have shown this photograph in two videos that I made last year, measuring curvature from lighthouse measurements and testing earth models and a correction. Now, I had said in the last video that we had two different vertical datums going on. So there's a little bit of a difference between mean high water, where the lighthouses are shown on nautical charts, and NAVD 88, where I was set up at my control point. Thankfully, I had some tidal benchmarks nearby. I did some field work, and I found the difference between those two was about 4 feet. And before your eyes glaze over, this just means that NAVD 88 is 4 feet below mean high water. And so what's happening is, I had set my crosshairs, my scope of my total station, to a vertical angle of zero. So it's set horizontal at my position. That means the horizontal crosshair is horizontal at my control point. And we look through the scope. That allows us to project that horizontal crosshair across anything that appears in that scope. Now let's think about this logically. We have the horizontal crosshair at an elevation of 76.83 feet. And Halfway Rock Lighthouse has an elevation of the light on NAVD 88 of 80 feet. Then we have Seguin Island Lighthouse, which has an elevation of the light of 184 feet on NAVD 88. Now think about that. This horizontal crosshair is telling us everything we need to know. This line is horizontal at my position. It is projected over these two targets across this water. Halfway Rock Lighthouse, which is taller than my position, appears below. Quite a bit below, as you can see. I mean, it's unquestionably below my horizontal crosshair. And then Seguin Island Lighthouse, which is more than twice the height of Halfway Rock because it's on a very tall island. The elevation of the light is 184 feet. That elevation is more than twice the elevation of Halfway Rock over here. Think about this logically. Seguin Island appears far below Halfway Rock. This horizontal line from my scope is far above those two targets. What must be happening to the surface of the Earth between my viewing position and those two lighthouses? It must be curving away from this horizontal line. So the surface of this water must be curving away. Now, this particular picture doesn't stand alone. It is not its own photograph. There are many others like it. You can find it on Jesse Kozlowski's website. There's going to be a link down below in the description. You should definitely check it out. So he has got Earth's curvature plainly visible. He's got a collection of several photographs that you should check out, and they're very compelling. And you can see that the surface of the Earth must curve away from the horizontal. It's a very cool series. All right, that's all I really have for you today. I hope you have a great day. Hope that you're not getting too bogged down in the COVID lockdowns. And I hope that this just helps you get away from all that stress for a little while you think about how logical this is, that the surface must be curving away with this information that you see here. Even if you didn't know the elevations of these items, these targets, we still see that they're falling away from the horizontal. I say falling in quotation marks, but you know. The surface of the Earth curves.